Welcome to a Disneyland Paris vlog. I'm so excited. 4:55 in the morning. It's so early. And we are currently sitting in the Eurostar departure lounge. I was gonna film a bit earlier, but honestly, we had the smoothest journey getting here. We got an Uber from Rachel's house.
Yeah.
It was pretty damn cheap, like less than a tenner each. We like just strolled through security, got here at the exact right time.
Yeah, we got here and the line opened and we were in like, I don't know, the first, probably like 20 people, 30 people.
Yeah.
And yeah, so smooth.
It's so smooth.
Yeah.
We got here 90 minutes before our train is due to leave at 5:59 a.m. And we've got through in like, as you can tell, less than half an hour, which is pretty good going. The only issue being the Pret is not yet open and we are both hungry. But honestly, I cannot believe that we're going to Disneyland Paris today.
So like, excited.
We've not had our Disney park fix since 2018.
Yeah, literally so long.
Well, you saw we went on a Disney cruise last year. Maybe you did, maybe you didn't, but we
that
did.
Got
there's
a
vlog.
Little Disney fix, but we're ready for the park.
I'm so ready for, I'm just ready to see Mickey Mouse and give him a hug, I won't lie to you. But I'm unbelievably excited and I'm gonna bring you along the entire journey, so yeah, can't wait. See you in a bit. We're emerging into the light. It's like being birthed.
It's too early.
It's far too early. But there she is, there's the Eurostar. We go. We've got one more stop to go, and I just thought I'd point out we are on a double-decker train, which is quite cool. So we're upstairs, which is fun. And we're just going from Val Europe out of this very dirty window. And then we'll be on our way, well not rather on our way, we'll be arriving in Disneyland pretty soon. We made it.
Yay,
we made it off the metro and got into Disneyland, spent about 15-20 minutes trying to figure out where to get the bus from for our hotel. There were no signs like there used to be. Oh, the bus is coming now, which we're about to hop on. We just changed our clothes, put our stuff in the locker. I'm very sweaty, it's hot. And now we're gonna get on that bus and go to Disneyland. Is this real life? Am I really here?
It's so happy a dream. It's like a dream, it's like a dream.
Happy anniversary, Disneyland Paris. Disneyland Paris. Oh, this is far too much. Damn it. She's so freaking pretty. Surely it's not real. Surely we're not here. Oh, we just saw Winnie the Pooh and that sent me. Oh my god. It's ridiculous because we're in a hot dog shop, but I want to cry because it's so familiar. We're starving, so we came for hot dogs from Casey's, but the parade is about to come past, the new 30th one, so we're both like losing our shit. But I got one with cheese. Oh my Jesus.
Ooh, that
looks, oh god, I can't even open it. My Jesus. There we go. It's got like cheese sauce, crispy bacon and onions. Whoa. Rich got a plain one and we got fries. No, you're not boring, you're not. The boat, Thunder Mountain, it's all so pretty. As you may have just seen, we did the carousel, which was a fun little starter ride. Everything has quite long wait time, so we're walking to Phantom Manor now, which we think has about a 15 minute wait at the minute, which is all right, so I think we'll tick that one off the list. Trying to not get the child in shot, but we were going in Haunted Mansion and then Mickey appeared, so we're gonna go meet Mickey. amazing Mickey reunion. It was so, so cute. After that, we hopped on Haunted Mansion as we initially planned to, and now we've come to Pirates. Yay! We just got off Pirates and it was so fun. Literally what I was gonna say. Two drops and I forget how big they are every time. And as we approached it, I was like, oh, actually I'm a bit scared. But it was so good. Although there was two girls in our row and we got pulled forward in the queue because there's four to a row. And as we went to sit down, they just didn't move. And Rachel had like 1 foot that could fit in, and we were like, can we move?
Like, am I gonna be able to get on this ride?
Can you please just shuffle? And then the cast members told them to move, and then we all fit in, and I was like, so they were just taking up space. They were just not letting someone else on. So that was weird. But anyway, we haven't talked about our Mickey meet and greet yet, but it was amazing.
It was so cute.
It was so adorable.
It
I love him.
So spontaneous.
Oh, it was. Like, I had no idea he would be there. And he was in the cutest little like 30th anniversary Haunted Mansion outfit, which was so sweet.
Waited.
Yeah, it was probably like 10 minutes.
It was really cool.
And in the other like pavilion where you meet him, it's like 50 minutes, 55 minutes. So like, so good. But now we're queuing, well not queuing, now we're walking to Indiana Jones. I've not done this for a while. I remember it knocked me about a bit last time. So
it is
a bit violent. So I might need a little sit down to recover after this one, but we'll see how it goes. Survive Indiana Jones. Didn't knock me about as much as I'm used to, but in that tight little loop I was like, I did not know which way was up and which way was down. It was a lot. But after that we headed over to Star Tours. And it was so good. It was the best Star Tours ride I'd ever had, and I love Star Tours anyway, but it was like a new sequence that I'd not seen. It was so, so good. Like, everyone in the room was vibing with it. It was a good time. And then we went and grabbed a Mickey premium bar, which I didn't even film for the vlog. What a failure. And we went to go wait for the parade and then realized it was in an hour, not half an hour. So we've come to quickly go on the teacups and hopefully still get a spot for the parade. But yeah.
I can't believe it.
Oh my.
I was on TV!
We're waiting for the parade, is Ron.
Right at the start.
Yeah, we're right at the start. We probably should have come a bit earlier, but we managed it just about. It was a tough one. Teacups were so cute. It was really,
so
really sweet.
But
I'm so excited to see this parade. I blimmin' love this parade. I prefer it to Festival of Fantasy. Rach doesn't, but I do. So I'm very, very excited to see it. Oh, Mary and Bert! Oh my god, I've never seen it from here, it's amazing! doing for us. The parade was amazing, so so good. Rachel got all the freaking men's attention, I'll tell you that.
And Madden, Crystal,
yeah.
Wasn't that fun as well?
Who was it? There was a few. But it was so fun, like so so amazing. Our grand plan after that was to run to Big Thunder to get on it quickly. It would. We were there very quickly, given our spot was right at the start of the parade. But it was close. It was damp. So we got a cold drink and came over to Buzz instead. So yeah, now here we are.
Zurg is using the stolen battery cells to energize his secret weapon. Our mission is to find his robots and his secret weapon and blast them. Squadron will retrieve the power.
Buzz was fun. Rachel absolutely smashed me. I am awful at those cheating games.
I didn't even do that good.
I know, I'm just really bad. I'm so, so bad.
I got like 18,000.
I got 8,000. It was very poor. Bearing in mind the maximum score you can get is 999,000.
Yeah, how do you get
literally
that?
Literally how? Oh. Anyway, we saw the line for Big Thunder on the app was only 40 minutes and we were like, you know what, it's reopened, there's thunderstorms scheduled for tomorrow, so we were like, let's just get in the queue and make sure we get to do it at least once on this trip, because if we didn't get to do it all, I think my heart would break. We're doing a game of Guess What I'm Thinking of Disney Park Space Edition. Yeah. So, go.
An alternative to Disney Heads Up.
Yeah.
You can't get in Paris.
No, apparently not. Okay, right, go.
So I think of something.
Okay.
So,
have you thought of it? Okay, right, okay.
Is it an attraction?
Is it a character? Is it a show? Is it a parade? Crikey. Is it a restaurant?
No.
Is it a piece of merchandise?
No.
Is it... Oh god, this will be a while. We've now established it's a hotel. Is it... Oh god. Once we established it was a hotel, I got it relatively quickly. It was the Contemporary Resort. Yeah. We've made it to the stairs. Our game made time pass so quickly. But that means, as you can see from the track right there, we're about to board. How exciting! Oh, look, there it is! We made it! Big Thunder. It was everything I remembered it to be and more. Like, it was so, so good. This fringe is... Oh, fringes aren't made for rides, guys. but it was so, so amazing. Like, loved it so much. We were going to go to the shop straight after, and then we saw Hyperspace Mountain was 25 minutes. So we were like, let's just go.
Violent.
So good though. The music is just amazing.
Yes.
And like when you were waiting to launch out of like that thing, oh, the build up and the music is just.
And then you go so fast.
So good. Star Wars, like just pure Star Wars gold. So fun. Bit shaken. Think we're gonna go look in some shops now.
Yeah.
Yay. We did have to wait a little while, but we've made it into Vapiano and we're both very hungry, so very excited for this. Hello, as you can probably tell from the state of this, it's a little bit later on. Last thing you saw was a clip where I cut off mid-sentence at dinner, but we had a lovely meal at Vapiano. It did not take anywhere near as long as I thought it would, considering it was really busy. And what I was going to say to you was I did get some merchandise today. Only one item, which is good, but I bought a new t-shirt, which I'm going to wear tomorrow. Rachel bought the same one. We're going to twin. Yes. It's very exciting. Very cute vibes.
Big reveal tomorrow.
Big reveal. Oh, I can see you in the mirror. That's funny. Hello. But I just thought, because we just got back to the hotel after we popped to World of Disney so Rachel could get her size in the t-shirt, we came back to the hotel, got our bags out from the storage where we put them earlier, which by the way, it was a right game trying to get them in, like none of the lockers were working. Turns out it was the locker's fault, not our fault, so that's good. But we got our luggage out successfully, checked in, and now we're in our room, so I thought I'd do a quick little room tour. So our main door is here, nothing special, and then if you turn around, here's a brief overview, there's Rachel. And here is our bathroom. I'll just turn the light on. We both just had showers and feel like fresh new women. But there's just a sink there. It's actually a really nice shower, although no door here, which is a bit weird, but you know, we move. Toilet, standard. And then, oh, it comes with those tiny little hotel towels, you know, the awkward ones that don't actually wrap very well. Anyway, we've got a light here, lovely full-length mirror. There we are. And a double bed. I thought we weren't sure if we were getting a twin or a double, but we've got a double, so yeah. We live with it. There's me again in another mirror with a little side table here with all of our stuff on, my mini ears that I've made myself. Hair dryer, sort of a mini open hanging wardrobe. There's two plugs here and a plug underneath each of, oh no, there's only a plug on that side. That's weird. Yeah, there is. I feel like there is one under here.
I guess the
TV. Yeah. Yeah, there is one under here. Okay, so we'll figure that out.
Yeah.
And TV there. And that is a lovely overview of the room.
Yeah. Shout out to a man on reception. He was so nice.
He was very nice.
Had the hiccups.
Yeah. He dealt with Rachel's hiccups very, very well. But for now, I bid you good night. We are going to go collapse.
Yeah.
And I'll see you in the morning. Bye. Morning.
Morning.
Look at our t-shirts. We're properly twinning today. It is currently 8:04 and we're gonna head down to breakfast in our hotel now because we are staying at the Hotel B&B.
Yeah.
So we do get a bed and breakfast. But I'd just like to remind you that this is what my fringe and my face look like before it all melts off during the course of the day and I come home looking like I did last night. So remember, I was put together at one point.
Well, it might be the rain that ruins it today. It's supposed to be rainy today.
It is. I haven't put my umbrella in. Thank you for that reminder.
Yeah,
oh my god. But anyway, we're going to head to the studios today for opening. And I think we're going to try Crush Coaster first. See how it goes. But just before we go, I want to show you the view from our window because I forgot to do that in the room tour. And it is really actually very pretty. I'll just, oh god, open the window. So this is our hotel. Very French chateau vibes. And then look over there, you can sort of see the forest and everyone walking down here. It's very lovely. Oh, there's a child. Right. But yeah, that's sort of an update of what we're hoping to be up to today, and I'll catch up with you in a bit. So we've just come to breakfast. It's a full like continental, so nothing hot, but they have pan au chocolat, which look good. Also got a croissant because pastries, more carbs in the bread, a tiny bit of ham, an apple and a yogurt, because best believe I want to load up as much as I can for today. Rachel got pretty much the same, but two pan au chocolat instead of a croissant. Pavilion in Epcot, but actually in France. We tactically decided to skip Crush, which was 60 minutes, and we've come to Ratatouille, where single rider is 5 minutes, and this ride gets to like 60 minutes for like, oh, two people, glasses. Don't forget your glasses. Oh god, oh god. But we're speeding through, and we're gonna be on and off in like 2 minutes. Oh my god, we're right at the front already. I have never walked onto a ride so quickly in my life. Oh my god. Reference, it started absolutely chucking it down when we left the hotel, but then it stopped when we got here, which is good. But they've started closing some rides now. It's not raining yet, but they seem to think it's going to be pretty horrific in like 5 minutes. So we're walking to Tower of Terror at the minute. I have never walked onto a ride as quick as I walked onto Ratatouille, and it was Ratatouille, like,
so good.
In Florida, that's probably like 70 minute wait all day every day at the minute because it's new, so like, very impressed. And we got on at the same time, even though we're single rider, and on that ride you're not really like talking to the person next to you because it's a little like film thing, so it was really great timing, to be honest.
Yeah.
But yeah, Tower of Terror now. Might wee myself, little bit scared. Peep us. Rachel posing me, arms in the air, having a great time. The camera's shaking because I'm still shaking. Rachel can confirm for the vlog that I was pooping at my pants before that one. But as soon as we were on it and we did that first drop, I was like, I remember every reason why I love it. Like when you're on it and the belts, because they're like elasticated, so they're not quite fully down and you're like flying off your seat. Oh, it's so fun. So good. But now I'm about to buy this little pin, if it'll focus. Nope. Well, it's a little castle pin and it's super cute. And I've realised, oh nope, there was something else there. And I've realised that we're never going to find any 30th anniversary pins on this trip, to be honest. So they're just nowhere to be found. They sold out so long ago. But I thought I'd get one thing to, you know, have for the trip on my lanyard. So because of the rain, basically everything over in the other park was closed. They have reopened now, but it felt like, well, they're super long waits now because everyone's gone to them. So we came over to this park, to the Disneyland park, here's a castle. We popped into a shop quick and then realised that the new parade was about to start, so we've secured a spot down like near the hub bit and we're about to watch it. And I'm very excited because we caught glimpses of it yesterday when we were eating our hot dogs when we first got here. So I'm excited to see it like in its full glory now.
Also, Mickey was waving when we came into the park. He was. I just love that touch.
In both parks he was waving, yeah, as we came it's in. So it's so nice. So, so nice. An amazing parade, but now it's time for the Blanche Neige.
Nice, there we go.
We just did our Tigger meet and it was so sweet. We decided to go meet him and it was so good. I was just, I loved it. I love meeting characters. And he was like telling me about how he was keeping fit over the pandemic, lots of bouncing. It was quite funny. And now here they come. We're in the queue for Mary and Bert and they look so sweet. They're just coming. I don't know if you can see on there, but they meet here in the grandstand banister thing, whatever you want to call it, but I'm very excited. Yeah, I agree. Oh, look at him. We've just come for lunch at Colonel Katie's Pizza Outpost and Mickey Pizza! Yeah! Can't wait to eat this! I'm so excited. Hello, it has been a little while since I've updated you. Last thing I think you may have seen was when we started meeting characters. So we, I know, that was a while ago. So we initially queued up for Tigger. It's very windy, so I hope you can hear me. I'll bring the camera closer. We initially queued up for Tigger, sort of over in that direction. We're just on Main Street at the minute. And we met Tigger and he was great. He was really funny. He did some like great interaction. And then we headed up to the gazebo up there where we met Mary and Bert, which I know you filmed a few clips of, but that was so lovely. It was so, so cool. And like the parade started while we were meeting them at the gazebo. So I just had this moment of, we'd had this conversation with Mary and Bert and we were smiling for a photo, and like right down the middle in front of me, the parade was just going down towards the castle, and I was like, is this real? Like, what is happening? Like, it was insane. And then we queued up for Pooh and it was so good. All my dreams came true. We got to meet Pooh, and so now we've ticked off the characters that I cared most about for sure. Like, oh, it was so, so good. At that point, I was dying because my feet hurt so much.
We were just doing like sitting down.
Yeah, so we went to fill our magic first, which was so much better than I thought it was.
Amazing.
Like, the French version was really, really cool. They had a new scene from Coco in there, which was really good. It was really, really cute. And then we, since we were there, the thing with the shortest wait in the park was Star Tours, basically. So we hopped on Star Tours for a second ride, and that was really fun. We had the scene that I always have, which is Darth Vader and the underwater bit, and yeah, always get that one. But it's okay, because we had a different one yesterday. And then we decided we'd try to do the Lion King show, except we got there like 15 minutes before it started, and we didn't even get in. Like,
so go early.
Yeah, go like half an hour early minimum if you want to get in. Like,
we're gonna try and do it.
Yeah, I think we're gonna try for tomorrow. It was a toss up between parade today or that tomorrow, so we've come for parade today, which is why we sat on Main Street an hour early. It's really windy and actually quite cold. And I'm in a short sleeve t-shirt and shorts. Rachel bought a jacket, which was very wise. So I'm gonna try not to freeze during this hour. But I feel like freezing is better than sweating like I would tomorrow. So, swings and roundabouts. But yeah, I'll keep you updated. Lovely time at the parade. It was so fun, apart from children who sort of got in front of us last second and we were like, we've been here an hour, but okay. But it was really fun. Mary and Bert, who we met, like waved at us both. It was so cute. It was really, really cute. But it was absolutely freezing. Like, it was freezy. So we decided to quickly pop back to the hotel, which took us probably, it will take us like an hour in total gone back and then come back to the park. So we've had a quick freshen up and got our jumpers and our jeans on rather than our shorts and skirts. And we're gonna head back to the studios for the last hour that it's open in hope that wait times are a little lower so we can hop on some stuff. Come on, Crush, come on. Look at this lovely blue sky at studios. The bluest it's been all day. Super quick, like the quickest I think I've probably got on it.
Such
like
a fast queue.
It was definitely less than 50. Well, no, it's probably actually bang on 15
yeah,
minutes.
Yeah, about 15 minutes, including like the bit after the pre-show.
Yeah.
It was really
super
good.
Quick. We were front row.
Yeah.
It was so fun. But then we like went straight to Crush, got there like 15 minutes before park close.
Yeah.
It said 60 minute wait. It was probably what, like 20
minutes? I
think 20
we 25.
25.
Yeah.
And it was so good. So much better than I remember, like.
Amazing.
It's much more of a roller coaster than I remembered, like. Oh, but it was so
I
good.
Love it. It goes backwards.
Yes.
That's like my favourite.
Backwards
thing
drops.
The ride.
So fun.
So good.
So fun. But anyway, now we're gonna go over to Disneyland Park and grab some food, I think.
Yay!
Yay! Back we go to the Disneyland Park. We're in Cafe Hyperion because nothing else in Disneyland Paris seems to do fast food stuff. Rachel's got nuggets. I've got a burger, and it was cheaper to get it with a yogurt than it would be to just get a burger, fries and a drink. So, I mean, it wasn't cheaper, it was the same price, so I just got it. You could also get ice cream, but it was only almond ice cream, and your gal can't eat almonds, so it's a yogurt for me. Good vibes. Anyway, I'm gonna eat because I'm hungry. We decided there's no time like the present, so we came to Peter Pan. I'm filming this on my phone after Peter Pan, but this is literally like walk on. Like, this is the first queue we've hit. Madness. Yay! Made me sob. They just brought out Mickey in his 30th outfit to make us all cry on our way out too. We're back. After a very unmagical bus ride. I have never experienced anything like trying to get on the shuttle buses back to the partner hotels. It was just pure like shoving people in the street. At one point Rachel got pushed down so that she was like this against me, and I was like, this girl is gonna be trampled and die. So I'm like lifting Rachel up, hoping she can still breathe, as someone else just keeps shoving. It was, oh, and then we got on the bus and the bus driver was playing that Oh Happy Day and his like whale
like
music. Yeah,
and like people are literally like, honestly, never been so squished. Even like the tube at rush hour, like worse, way worse. So
but anyway, we're back now. My feet hurt like they've never hurt before. but on a very positive note, the fireworks were amazing. The so new pre-show, good. Insane. Oh my God. Like, that is truly what they mean when they say, like, innovation. Like, yeah. It was so cool.
Oh, it was so amazing. Cool.
I loved it. And Illuminations was just really fun. And we were in such a good spot. Like, I said to Rach that I'm much more of a fireworks person and a projection person. But that's mostly because I can never see the projections. And we were in such a good spot that, like, for the first time ever, I saw, like, pretty much everything we were meant to see, and I felt like I finally saw that show how like they want you to see it. And yeah
we were pretty close. It was really good spot.
It was a really good spot,
and it was a good spot for the D light as well, because
yeah,
you could see, like, the drones kind of make the Mickey but the 30
yeah
next to the castle.
It was
really good.
It was so nice. As soon as Anna and Elsa came on, I got emotion. Then when they did the whole Anna's frozen, oh Lord. And then they went into Viewer Lee and it was just, I was a goner. I was sobbing.
Yeah, me too.
It was so magical. And then Mickey on the way out was just, oh, so, so lovely. But anyway, I'm very, very tired.
Bedtime.
It's bedtime. It's bedtime. So,
yeah. See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow. Bye. Good morning.
Morning.
Last park day today. I know already. We're gonna head down to breakfast now, and I think we're gonna go to the studios first. Who knows? To try and get some of the Toy Story rides done, because they've sort of had longer wait times than they probably should have the whole time we've been here. So I think we're just gonna get them done.
Yeah.
And then we want to see Piglet. We want to go see the Lion King show. And those are the objectives. And the rest of the day, we just want to
go with the flow
and go on Big Thunder.
Big Thunder. Sure.
But yeah, that's about it. So we're gonna go have breakfast now, and I'll see you in a bit. I have never got into a park as quickly as we just did. We saw, like, yesterday, we saw the extra turnstiles open for general entry as soon as extra magic hours were done. So we were, like, waiting for it today. We saw the surge begin. We swiftly walked, went first in our turnstile, straight through. But this ride, the parachute drop, is already 25 minutes, which isn't that bad, but it's, like, give or take, like, this one gets long. It shouldn't, I don't think, in my opinion, but we've just done single rider, which should be about 5 minutes, so happy days. I literally got on the first round after we walked up to the ride. Amazing. And Rachel was the one behind me. There she is. Yay. Soldiers was really fun. It was really good. And then we went straight over to RC Racer, which we didn't do single rider on because I'd not been on it before and I was a bit scared. I was quite nervous about it, but we went on it. It was so fun. Like,
so
way
good.
More fun than I thought. It's super short, but it was really good.
Yeah.
And like, now I know that I love it as well.
It is such a fun one.
No, it wasn't that long really.
20 minutes.
Yeah, and it gets up to like 45 an hour, so like, that's okay. And now we're waiting 10 minutes for Slinky Dog, which is good. And it's currently 10:06,
yeah.
So the park's been open for 36 minutes and we've done two rides, so pretty good going. Yes! join you from the floor. We came into Disneyland Park, it was packed outside, it took us a while to get in. And then the parade was on when we got here, so we were like, well, let's just watch this, so fun. Not the normal parade, obviously, the anniversary parade. It was so fun, we watched it from where they came out, the entrance, and then ran down the sort of arcade corridor and caught them in front of the castle as well, which was really nice. Then since that ended, it was about like 10 past 11 and the Lion King show starts at 12. And yesterday we got here 15 minutes early and we did not get in. So we got here 45 minutes early and it is already rammed. So praying we get into this one because it's crazy, crazy busy, but fingers crossed we make it in. I really, really hope we do because we're gonna be sat on the floor for like 45 minutes in the sun. We made it, we're in. In hindsight, we were probably a little early, but like, I'm not mad about it really. Like, it was the sake of probably like 15 minutes and we might not have got in. So we didn't have to wait in the sun for the whole time. They moved you up and down and into new places, so it wasn't, you weren't in one spot for too long, which was good.
But we've been put on like the very side, on the first row though, so that's cool. But yeah, time for a show.
So we did successfully go to the Lion King show. We made it in. We were on the second row, which was pretty good. It was really, really good. It was so lovely. The acrobatics were amazing. The singing was really good. I can't lie, my eyes did close a few times, but that wasn't because the show wasn't good, because it really was really good. I was just really, really tired and we're in a dark room. But it was amazing. Rachel, you loved it.
Yeah, it was so good. I loved it. I teared up a few times, but it was really good.
Yay! Oh, yay! And after that, we went to go meet Piglet, which we did. It wasn't too long a wait, to be fair. So we had a little hug with Piglet, which was really sweet. And then we came here to grab some lunch. So we just had a Mickey pizza that is now in our bellies. And we've done pretty much everything on our list now, so we're just gonna go to the railroad now and go on a little train ride, which will be cute. I also forgot to say, while we were waiting in the queue for Piglet, Belle walked by us towards the Princess Pavilion, which was really cool. We were like, shook. Then the Evil Queen walked past and we were like, what is going on? And then, after we met Piglet, we were walking to here where we are now, which is Bellinotte, I think it is. We heard this voice behind us go like, excuse me, princesses, and we turned around and we were in the way of freaking Cinderella. Like, she's just walking on behind us and we were like, oh my god, I'm so sorry, so sorry. I don't think she minded though, she was really sweet. And yeah, so we got to see two princesses really quickly, which was really, really nice.
Starstruck, to be honest, by Cinderella.
Yeah, we were starstruck. I always get starstruck when I see a princess because there's no way to meet them here other than queuing for like 2 hours, which is not an option in my opinion. So anytime I see them, it makes me really happy. But anyway, onto the train.
That was so nice. What a lovely, lovely view.
So what did we just do? We had lunch.
Yeah, we had lunch and then we had like a little photo shoot.
Yeah, we went just round Main Street. Yeah.
Like a little castle in front of the train station with a little gazebo.
Yeah, and it was really nice to just wander down Main Street with the music and just like have a chill time. And now we're in quite a long queue for the train. But it feels like it's just, you know, a nice thing to do. And it's a really nice view up here. So yeah, that's what we're doing. See you in a bit. Wow. Hello. So, updates. We did the railroad. It was really sweet. I nearly fell asleep multiple times again. And yeah, it went through Pirates of the Caribbean and you could see like the Jack Sparrow scene, which I didn't know was a thing.
And like through It's a Small World, which is the closest we're gonna get this trip.
Yeah, so, yeah. It was really nice. And just went to get a Mickey ice cream bar, which we both devoured. And now we are sat like sort of in the hub area. People walking past me. We're sat sort of like in this area next to the castle with like stages because we're gonna wait for the 30th parade again, but this time in a different angle. So hopefully we'll be able to see the characters and the stages even better and it should be good.
Oh.
boldly waited for Big Thunder to reopen. We didn't get in line, we just sort of sat nearby and then jumped in the queue as soon as it reopened. We've been in the queue for less than 20 minutes. This is insane. we're getting on, yay! So after our extremely lucky ride on Big Thunder, it was like 20 minutes, so fun, can't believe it happened. We've come over to the little boat ride, which, do you know what it's actually called?
I think it's like La Paz, but that's much better, should be much better for the
pronunciation. Yeah. It's a little boat ride. Yeah, so I think we're just gonna head on this quickly and then head over to the studios maybe and try Tower of Terror depending on wait time.
But
yeah. Yeah, bit of a contrast between this and Tower of Terror, but oh well. Yeah. Fun. I love the little stories on it. It was way better than I remember as well. Like, I didn't even realize they had the whole Aladdin Cave of Wonders thing, so that was really cute. I'm just sitting now on Main Street, at the top of Main Street. Rachel's just gone to the loo. We just came to sit down to rest our feet because I forgot how much of a toll Disney takes on your body. It's been so long, but doing the parks open to close for like almost 3 consecutive days, like, I am dead. Like, I am dead. Probably not helped by the fact that I now work an office job 9 to 5 where I sit down all day. but yeah, feet hurt. But I think we're gonna head over to the studios now and go on Tower of Terror and probably grab some food and then come back to this park and either do maybe Dumbo or Big Thunder again, depending on what wait times are like, and then get ready for the parade. Hello! It's dark now. I think last time I updated you was probably when we were going on Tower of Terror. But to be fair, since then we walked back to the Disneyland park and went to Hakuna Matata for dinner, and it took ages.
Yeah. Really good food.
Good food, but
a long wait. I think I waited like 40 minutes.
It was insane. Like, it was so long.
Yeah.
But it was good food and we needed it.
Yeah. It's good. It's like a few different foods.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then we wanted to go get Dole Whip, but then found out the place that sells Dole Whip was closed, which was our fault for not doing it earlier. But you know, we live and we learn, and we've had lots of Mickey bars, so it's okay.
Yay.
And then we were going to do one final ride. Dumbo said it was 20 minutes. Went to Dumbo, it was 45.
Too long
for Dumbo. Sorry, Dumbo. So we came over to the Star Wars area because I'm getting my boyfriend a Star Wars present because he's a little nerd. And then we decided to go on either Star Tours or Hyperspace. And we went for Hyperspace because they were 25 minutes each. And like I said the other day, Hyperspace like shakes me up. But this time I took Rachel's very good advice and didn't put my head back, apart from when we were upside down. And oh, it made such a difference. Like, it was so much better. So really like that now. Never gonna put my head back and follow the safety instructions again. Would recommend. But anyway, now the castle looks something like that, except less blurry in real life. So we're gonna grab a spot for the fireworks because it is 10:29. Also, Rachel bought a spirit jersey.
Oh my god, yeah, I bought a spirit jersey.
Look
at it. I decided I wanted it yesterday evening and then I couldn't find it for ages. Like, I went in the store and then this is like the last one on the rack, about the third time we're going in the store today.
It was honestly, hang on, let me get it. Oh, it's so nice. So you've got like the castle and like the dragon, Thunder Mountain, like all, like Star Wars, like so many different rides. A glorious jumper. I wish you could see the colors there. It's Rachel's first spirit jersey, which is mad to me because you've been to Disney like so much as well. But it's so nice, and like when we finally saw it in the shop, it was like fate. Like, it was the last one that girls had in their hands, and they put it back down on the hanger, and Rachel was like, it's mine, and it was in the right size, and just Mwah, chef kiss. But anyway, now we're gonna find a fireworks spot. Coming at you from the floor. we're towards the back of Main Street, on the left hand side, because D-Light is on the right hand side, so we wanna make sure we can see that. Okay, we've got 5 minutes till it starts, so I'm just sitting myself on the floor, and I'll be ready to go as soon as we begin, and just enjoy the last bit of Disney magic. Rachel has a cookie.
It's from the cable car bakery, and it's like just chocolate chip cookie.
Like, oh, really yay, I'm glad it's really good. Yay! But not long to go now. Oh, I feel a bit emotional. We've given ourselves a solid 15-20 minutes to recover, but if I'd recorded this straight after, floods of tears. Again, Frozen, first time in forever, Preece just set me off. Didn't stop until the end. You cry at the Nemo bit,
yeah,
and then
Nemo bit. Anyone who's a fan of Nemo egg,
oh god.
Fireworks,
can
you believe it?
So good. But we just came to the side of Main Street to like sort of get out of the way because it was so overwhelming yesterday. So we've just chilled out, waited for the Main Street to clear out, so now it's like not empty, but like it's very quiet compared to how it was at first. So it feels worth it to wait the extra like 10-15 minutes just to not have to like fight your way out of the park, because it sort of ends it on a sour note otherwise. But instead I'm feeling very
good.
Yes, sad, but good in a good way.
Yeah.
But yeah. Oh, time to say goodbye.
I don't want to leave.
Oh. Bloody love that girl. Look at her skipping down Main Street. Oh dear. Oh, look how lovely and empty it is. Oh. Bye, Castle. Bye.
It's not goodbye, it's the real soon.
It's true. We're back, we made it. Oh, honestly. The difference between last night and tonight in terms of the end of the evening is just stark differences, because last night we rushed out with everyone else. I was very panicky because it was just a lot of people. We were shoved and pushed onto a bus. It was suffocating. It took ages to get back to our hotel. Like, it wasn't a nice experience. Whereas tonight, conversely, we watched the fireworks. It was lovely. We chilled on the side of Main Street, we people watched as everyone walked by, we listened to the Main Street music, we waited until it was nice and quiet so we could say goodbye to the castle properly. And we left feeling very emotional, but then we headed down towards the bus, hanging at the back, and it was really super busy, but we just stayed out of the way. And then I thought, let's just check Uber. There were Ubers for €8. We tried for a while, but there was no chance that we were gonna get one. And then we met another couple from where are they from? Oh, they were from Abu Dhabi. And they were lovely, and they're on a trip to Paris. So we were chatting with them, and they were trying to get an Uber. And then I put our option on, like, you know, you can get like Uber Deluxe or whatever it's called. It was €10 instead of €8. So I just tried that, and after about 5 minutes, we got a ride. And he didn't cancel on us, he came and picked us up, he played jazzy swing music in the car all the way home. It was really simple, so between me and Rachel it was €5 each, and we were like, well, we missed out on getting a Dole Whip, so Dole Whip money for non-suffocating bus money, I'll take it. So we got home, and I just feel like, I feel very uplifted now, because we had a positive journey home, and it just felt like right to stick around and say goodbye to the castle like that.
Yeah.
Rich is just back from brushing it.
Sorry if you could hear me in the background.
No, funny. But yeah, thoughts on the evening, the day, everything?
Just the whole trip's just been so amazing.
It has been.
I cried a lot saying goodbye to the
family. Yeah, we both
but
did.
I just, like, I know it won't be as long again as it has been the last time. I think it was just so special, like, coming back to Disney after so long with the pandemic and everything. But yeah, it was a nice, like, end to the trip and not ending it with, like, the crowded bus, to be honest.
No, it was a really nice evening. I'm really glad we did Space Mountain again, and I know that it doesn't have to give me a headache anymore. And we had a good final ride on Tower of Terror, which was really, really nice. I feel like we got to do plenty of rides today, but we also got to, like, watch parades and then also just chill out. Yeah. And just, like, watch the world go by a bit and take in the atmosphere, which we both said is one of our favourite things about Disney.
Yeah, lots of people watching today.
Yeah, in a good way, in a good way. And I can't believe that tomorrow I don't have to put my feet through so much pain. To be fair,
you
Rachel,
forget about the foot pain, though.
You do, yeah. You leave with the good memories, not the foot pain memories.
Exactly.
But, like, Rachel has been an absolute gem, just letting me sit when I need to have 5 minutes to just sit and recover, putting my cardigan in her bag, putting my ears in her bag. What a little park buddy legend. She's a good egg, she's a good egg. Oh dear, but yeah, favourite part of the trip.
Oh, we were saying this earlier, it's so hard to pick one part, but I would say probably the 30th anniversary parade.
Oh, yes.
Especially because that's, like, unique to this trip, probably. That was, it's just amazing, like, the song is so good. Like, they did not have to go so hard for an anniversary parade.
But it is.
It's just every time, it's just so joyful, brings tears to my eyes. Amazing.
It is such a lovely parade with so many characters in.
I think
that's one of my highlights for sure. Like, I really can't pick one. That meeting Mickey again was amazing. Meeting Pooh again. Meeting Mary and Bert when the parade was going down Main Street.
That was a cool memory.
That was, like, insane. Yeah. So many good rides, like the first drop on Tower of Terror when I suddenly wasn't scared because I remembered how much fun it is.
Yeah.
Just so many good little memories
just
to take,
like,
away.
Little things. Just seeing, like, the castle again for the first time.
Yeah, seeing it at night as well.
Yeah, and, like, on the first day when we kind of walked in, just, like, walked down Main Street, got a Casey's Corner, and then the parade started. It was just...
It was bliss.
So magical.
Pure happiness. Pure happiness. I, like, there were so many ride photos of us where you could just see the joy on both of our faces.
Yeah.
Like, smiling so wide with hands in the air, like, and that just says it all really about, like, how lovely it is.
Yeah.
And yeah, I'm sure it won't be too long till we're back in somewhere Disney.
Yeah.
I mean, we've got a cruise book next year, so we'll definitely be on a cruise at some point next year.
Yeah.
So that's good. But yeah, it's been an amazing trip, and I'm gonna end the vlog here because tomorrow we're just probably gonna go to Disney Village and shop and then go home. So there's not much exciting. I feel like it would be too depressing to end it on I'm in a shop and now I'm
on
a train. So let's end it on this lovely recap instead. Thank you for watching. I make them mostly just so I can look back on, to be honest, because it's really fun to just watch your old holidays. But if you enjoyed watching it, that is a lovely thing to hear as well, so I hope you did. I don't have any more trips planned apart from the cruise, so hopefully I'll get something booked in so I can vlog something else again soon. But otherwise, yeah, I guess we'll see you later.
See you real soon.
Bye. Bye. Bare necessities, the simple bare necessities. Forget about your